Hello, Dara.
Hello, Clinton.
Could you get just a little closer to the screen? It was good before, but when you spoke, the volume went down. Can you just say something now?
Test. How is it
now? That's good. Yeah, that's better.
Yeah. Perfect.
Good. Don't go too far away, okay?
Okay. I stay here.
Thank you. So, there was a note from you or a message somewhere, and you told a little bit about your history, about you were born in Iraq. Is this what you said?
Yes.
Okay. Right. And how long ago did you come over to Germany?
It was 98, so it's 22 years.
Okay. And how did you pick Germany of all the places to go from Iraq?
Actually, my parents chose Germany. Due to some reasons, they chose some of the family was there. And so it was like to joining the family.
And in the 91 war, or whatever that was called over there, the 91 insanity. So something big happened. You were saying, you were mentioning something like that.
Yes, yes.
And what happened actually?
Okay, actually I was born in 91.
Okay.
And yes, and when it was like February 91, and when the war began, it was like my mother was pregnant, and my parents told me that they've been waiting so I can be born, so we can fly over to Iran. We've been in Iraq. In the Iraqi part of Kurdistan.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And it was like just waiting until I was born so we can fly over to Iran to some people and family we know, so we could be safe there.
Yes.
And I was 3 months old when we went over to Iran for I think 2 months or something like that. Until the Saddam's army went back out from the Kurdish region.
Okay. And I feel really touched by your clarity about what possibility management is. And somehow your commitment to taking a stand for that, especially for even people in Iraq or Iran, in Kurdistan. And I just want you to know that we will basically do whatever we can to support you to do that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And so I feel like this conversation and this process that we'll do is part of that, is part of empowering that, or making it possible for you to do that. Do you have a team? Is there anybody else from Kurdistan who is in your team for this stuff?
In Kurdistan, no. In Germany, here in Freiburg, I have my friends and people around me who I'm within a team, but in Kurdistan I have nobody. I have my father, who's also open for the kind of stuff, but we're not kind of working together in a team like that.
And what about your team in Freiburg? It's Freiburg, right?
Yes.
Freiburg.
Right.
Freiburg is a great town for transformation. I've been delivering transformation in Freiburg since the middle of the 90s. So.
Wow.
And yeah, it's been amazing there. So you're in a great place. Is any of your team in Freiburg interested in the project that you are putting together?
Totally, yes. I'm also now in contact with Oliver, and we are wanting to create a bridge house to come together with another friend of us and to do the next step, so we can really live together and live that kind of work in the daily life.
In Freiburg?
in Freiburg for is the first step, and when we get a momentum by the time, then we are open to move wherever it feels right. But for the moment, Freiburg and surrounding Freiburg.
Yeah. So I just want you to know that's what I'm doing too. You know, essentially we have a bridge house. We call it a writing house because we are dedicated to writing right now. So we and delivering projects and processes, but mostly writing. And so it's we have this focus. And so you would have a focus also. And so I'd just like you to know that when you get around to it, when it comes to that point of translating possibility management into what language would you translate it into?
It's Kurdish.
Kurdish, yeah. So yes. Is that spoken, I'm sorry for my ignorance, but is that spoken both in Iraq and Iran, Kurdish?
It's yes, but there are different dialects.
Okay.
Yes.
But what about the written language? The written language is...
The written language, I think it's same, depending on... There are four parts of Kurdistan.
Okay.
Yes, but in the Iranian and Iraqi part, it's the same.
Okay. So when it comes to translating sparks or building a website for possibility management in Kurdistan, that we'll support you with that. We can help you set up the framework. You know, we have an easy website to fill out. You know, you can copy, paste, and use whatever, just because it makes a lot of sense to bring it into that language.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So there's so many experiments, and there's so many sparks, and there's so many information to give in that language. So we would support you to do that.
Thank you. I saw the sparks also. Mm-hmm. I also watched them, and I'm not sure if I can translate that. My written Kurdish is good enough to translate that words, maybe. But if I feel the call, I could imagine to do it in a spoken language. Mm-hmm. To find a platform, so it's via audio instead of written.
Yeah, that works. Yeah. And I'm just saying, you know, if you really keep moving with this, then open up the chance, like somehow get in contact with people who would like to help. Because because we're all, I mean, every country in the world is in the same difficulty right now, which is we are using old thoughtware.
Yes.
Old thoughtware. And the result is war, conflict, survival, breakdown. It's old thoughtware. And we've been researching upgraded thoughtware, and that's what the processes are about. And the trainings and the skills are all about bringing new thoughtware to people, because we have good hardware. The hardware is good, but the thoughtware is very old.
Yeah.
And so school does not bring it, and you have to find something like possibility management, which is possible to bring the thoughtware, to go through the processes to upgrade the thoughtware, to grow up, basically to grow up.
Yeah.
And so the taking a stand for that to come into the Kurdish language is a big valuable thing. But I just want you to know there are people doing that in Egypt. There's people doing it in Turkey. There's people doing it here in Brazil. There's people doing it in Poland, you know, so that Portugal. There's people doing it, and it works. We know that it works. And we know the procedure for how to do this. So, I mean, I will send you a website. It's called how to create and expand the box in your area, how to do that.
Okay.
And so, but you don't have to do that now. I just wanted you to know it exists.
Yes.
And I'll send you that. I'll send you that. So, perfect. Yeah, thank you. So anyway, what I'm saying is your team, you can build your team more by telling people what you're doing. And then people who speak Kurdish, who are in Iraq or Iran or Kurdistan, you know, who would like to help you, you know, let them come in, let them help you. you know, let them come and help you. Okay, you don't have to do this alone. So you start building a team. Okay, thank you for having this part of the conversation.
Thank you.
So you contacted me because you noticed there's some emotion, there's reactivity, you notice some stuff going on and you'd like to make a shift with that.
Yes, yes.
Could you tell me what's going on?
Yes, there are actually like different topics, but I think I feel they result to the same.
Okay, so I just want you to know that I'm more interested in your feelings than in the story. So I am interested in the story, but when the feelings come up, please don't suppress them. If the feelings, like you already, there's already feelings right there. Okay, so we're going to go with the ones that come up. So don't try to complete the story by suppressing the feelings, okay? We have time, Okay, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but please go ahead.
Thank you. The point is, I live alone in Freiburg, and the strongest trigger, emotional trigger now is like the neighbors have two little children, two little girls, and when they run through their house, it's like I hear this stomping, and the stomping makes like my body is like frozen, and it's like death. It's like I feel bombs and war, and just by the sound, I feel like my whole body is in danger.
Thank you. Is that something you actually experienced, or is it imagined?
No, it's I don't know. I can't remember. But when I feel that, it's what I really feel, and I get the images and all the stuff. But it's not that I have memories. I have one. But it's not this where we've been captured by Iranian soldiers. I was 4 or 5 years old. But what it feels like for me is that it's even older than that, where I can't remember.
Meaning it actually happened, but you were 1 or 2 years old.
Yes, when it happened, I was a few weeks or months old when we fly over to Iran.
But where did you notice that? Where were the bombs? Were you still in your mother's belly?
Or this is what something I don't know. This is just what I feel.
Okay. But there's more dimensions. Give me a couple more dimensions. You mentioned it when you wrote to me.
Yeah. It feels like I'm trying to connect with what I feel now, because I feel the last day super fluid and can't really think clearly.
Don't worry.
Okay. The thing is, I also feel when the fear comes up, it comes like waves, like a few days or weeks, it's good. When I feel safe, when I feel nourished by contacts, by people around me. And when I'm more like in my cave alone and triggered by that, I feel also my left leg where it hurts a lot. It's like it becomes stiff and hard, the muscles. And it's like I can't run and can't fly away. I can't go. This is also a pattern of me, like to be very fast and very straightforward and direct. And when that fear comes up, I feel it mostly on the bodily level. It's like a few weeks and months where I really can consciously feel the fear that precisely in that depth. It's like just the first 6 months of this year, I couldn't sleep well. I was like sleeping 4 to 6 to 5 hours a night because my body and especially my solar plexus was like electric and like bumping really strong here.
Which is which feeling?
It's like adrenaline, like being fully awake and ready to fight, but it's more like getting beaten up into the belly, and it's like a shock. Like,
yes, which feeling is that?
It's fear.
Yeah, it's so important. It's so important to stay with that. it's so important for your inner navigating, to navigate what's happening, to just say fear, sadness, anger, joy, to notice. And don't go into other things like, yes, you notice your heart going like this and your leg like this and you're ready to fight or run. Stay with the feeling. Stay with God. This is fear.
Yes.
Okay. So there was some other, you mentioned something about intimacy or relating or something like that. Can you talk about that also?
Yes. It's like, I feel like that I'm able to connect to people on a certain level, but it's like, I feel it really in my chest and heart, like something wooden or of metal in my heart or in my chest that is like protecting me and not trusting human, not trusting people, just letting them into a certain zone, but not coming really close to me, I feel.
Could we start with that?
Yes.
I'd like to start with that. Could you just close your eyes? Just close your eyes. You have some tissues and stuff available, right? You have tissues and stuff. Good. Okay. Yeah, just close your eyes. Take a deep breath. Are you familiar with getting your energetic center and putting it on your physical center? And you have a grounding cord? Do you have a grounding cord now? What color is it?
It's yellow.
Okay, so mine is orangish with a little silver. It's an orange silver color. Yours is yellow. Good. And you have a bubble of space around you. You have your clicker and you make this bubble of space around you. Great. Super. So this thing, can you just sense into this wood or this metal around your heart? This just sense into it. Yeah, just sense into it. And I want you to click your clicker and go back to the first time where you noticed that, where the first time where it was necessary to have that around your heart. Yeah. Okay, you're back at this time. You have the same sensation. Yeah, that. And just keep letting it get bigger. Just keep letting it get bigger. You're about 16, 17, 18, 19% big with that, with the fear right now. Just keep letting it get a little bit bigger. I need it around 30% big. And then at about 21%, some sounds will start coming out. Just little sounds will start coming out. This is a safe place. You made a safe place for yourself. Yeah, you're doing super. Doing super. Yeah. You're great, 19, 20%. The sounds are just there, little sounds first. Try to not blow it out. You're really good at blowing this out and making it go away. So keep your lips closed. Keep your lips closed, okay? Yes. Yeah, and stay with the feeling. You're inner navigating now. Try to not swallow it down. You just swallowed the feeling down. Those are two ways to block the feeling. One is blowing it out your lips. The other is swallowing it down. And you're an expert at that. And right now we need you to not do either one of those. So keep your lips closed, breathe through your nose, and don't swallow it down and let the feeling get bigger. This was a time when it was an urgent thing. You had this, yeah. Yes, you're doing super. Just stay there. You don't have to understand, Dara. Just keep going. Yes, 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 super. You're doing super. Just stay with it. Do not try to understand. Don't blow it away. Don't blow it away. Stay with it. You can do this. You've worked hard to learn how to do this. You're doing super. Okay, I'm going to ask you questions. You just answer. Let your body answer. Is it daytime or nighttime? Just your body answer.
It's night, evening.
Yeah, evening. And you don't, it will feel like you're making the answer up. Don't worry. So it's evening time. Are you inside or outside?
I'm inside.
Is it your place or somebody else's place?
It's my space. I know exactly where I am.
Okay, how old are you?
I'm 7.
7 years old. And are you alone or with somebody else?
my family's there, the neighbors are there, and my grandmother is in front of me. She's dying. It's the last hour where she's, yeah, before she dies.
Okay. And what is happening?
I'm sitting in front of her.
Okay. And what's going on? Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, just keep going, Dara. Just don't even think about it. Let this get big, way big, bigger, bigger, bigger. Yeah, let the sounds come out. Yes, let it come big. Way big, way big, bigger, bigger. Don't even think about it. Yes, yes. Put your hands on your heart. Put your hands on your heart. Or put your hands out. Put your hands in your heart. Yes. Or put your hands out. Yes. Yes. Good. And let it get big. Way big. Super big. Don't do anything with your hands. Just put your hands. Just put your hands against your chest. Put your hands on your chest. Yeah. On your chest. Yes. Yes. And just let it. Yes. 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 Try to not blow it out. Dara, let that sound come out. It's really big sounds. And there's even maybe words in there. There's words like, who knows what the words are? I don't know what the words are. They could be things. Do you know what the words are? Just you did not get to say this. Go ahead, keep going.
Don't go.
Yes, exactly.
Don't go.
Yeah, try not to blow it out. Let the sounds get bigger, Dara, even louder.
Ooh.
Even louder. You keep going, whoa, like that, whoa. And there's big sounds in there. Don't do that. Try to let the big set, there's sobs in there. You have big, big, big crying sounds. Big, deep, from your heart. Yes, yes, yes. The sobbing sounds from your heart. Let that come out. Yes, yes, like that. Yes, take it, yes, exactly. Yeah, you're doing super. Yeah, that. Yes. Say, I feel sad because.
I feel sad because my grandmother is dying in front of me. I see her.
Yeah. Why does that make you sad?
It feels like she was the only person I really could trust.
Yeah, that's the thing.
And I feel left alone.
Yes, exactly. Keep your eyes closed. Say, what's that? Say that.
It's fear. It's fear.
What's the fear about? Say, I feel afraid because.
I feel afraid because I'm alone in the darkness.
What darkness?
I feel like we're at the. At her grave, it's like she was washed and now it's time to put her into the grave, and it's
yes.
dark, and it feels like the hope is died.
Yes.
It's the only.
You're doing super, Dara. Yes.
It it's like she was the only light in that darkness, and it died.
Yes.
And now I'm there and don't know what to do.
Yes. So stay with yourself. You're listening to your heart. You're doing great listening to your heart. So you're 7 years old, the only light in the darkness is going away. There's nobody to replace her. There's nobody around you to replace her. So what did you decide? Oh. Just say it.
I close all the doors around my heart, around my body.
Yes.
So nobody will touch me.
Yes.
And I don't trust anybody here.
Okay. Show me with your hands how you close the doors.
Like this.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, let yourself feel this.
And I feel it in my heart like a fist.
Yes. What is the door made of on your heart? What is it made out of?
It's a mix of stone and wood.
All right. And what is
the outside layer is wooden, and the inside that is closer to my heart is on stone. It's in stone.
Okay. And you were 7 years old when you did this?
Yes.
Okay. Let the feelings come up. Let them come up. Dara, just let them come. So, Dara, hold on. Will you slowly open your eyes just a little and look at me for a second? I need you to learn a different way. Can you see me? So yes. You have your eyes closed and you're going, whoa, like that. Whoa, like that. And that blows the energy out so that it doesn't really come out. It's, you blow it out in a way to make it go away. And that's not going to work for this. Okay. So what I want you to do is when it comes up, keep your mouth closed and let it get bigger so that the tears really come, or the anger really comes, or the fear really comes. But what you're doing is blowing it away. Wah, it's so much. Wah, I can't feel this. Wah, make it go away. Okay, that's the old thought map of feelings. That is, you try to make it go away. We're on the new thought map of feelings. Okay, so I need you to learn a new thing. Don't make it go away. You hold it in. What you're doing is catharsis. Trying to make it go away, catharsis. Okay, we do cathexis. That means you hold it in and it does its work, and then we can use it. But right now you keep blowing it away and we can't use it. All right? Okay, so this is gonna be new. This is new. So you hold it in, you close your eyes, you start feeling something, you hold it in and let it come out a different way. Okay. Don't try to make it go away. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. Okay, close your eyes. You're doing super. Just close your eyes. You're 7 years old. It's night. Your grandmother is dead. They have washed her body. They're putting her in the ground. It's over. Yes. 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 Yes, exactly. Keep going. Okay, so you're mixing two feelings together right now. What are the two feelings?
Anger and sadness.
Okay, it looks like something else then. You're mixing three feelings then.
Also fear.
Yes. And it looks to me like you're mixed. The big ones are sadness and fear. That's what it looks like. Yeah. Okay, yes. So you've been doing okay with the sadness, but the fear is not really coming out. So I would like if you could just put the sadness aside for just put it on a shelf for just a minute. Don't mix it together. Like, yes, 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 yes. Exactly. Put the sadness over there. We'll do that in a minute. And just let the fear come. And it's going to be loud. There's going to be pure fear. Yes, yes. Don't make it go out. No, keep it. Yes. Yes, keep going. Go, go, go. Yes, 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 yes. 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 Keep going. Keep going. Don't blow it out. Yes. 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 Stay with it. Stay with it. Keep going. You stay with the fear. Just fear. Only fear. You're starting to mix anger in. Don't mix the anger. Only fear. Just the fear. No, no, no. Keep it in. Don't blow it out. Just the fear. You're 7 years old. It's dark. There's no one anymore. You are lost. Go ahead. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Let the shaking happen. Let it be huge. Yeah. Put your head back. Put your head back. Let the scream out. It's a huge scream. Try to not do it like wah. Don't do wah. Just go ah. Just like the scream. Ah! Like that. No wah. Just go ah! Like that. Yes, you can find it. Yes. It's there. It's right there. It's been in there since you were 7. Go, 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 go. Yes, go. Yes, yes. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Yes. 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 Dara, that was pure fear. It was pure fear, no anger, no sadness mixed in. It was pure fear for a while there. Are you okay? Check yourself. Are you okay? You okay?
I'm okay. I'm a little distracted because the neighbors knocked.
Okay.
But I'm okay.
Do you need to tell them that you're okay? Do you need to tell them?
It's fine. They live in another building. It's too far to talk to them.
Okay. All right.
It's okay.
Okay, that was super. Dara, keep your eyes closed. Kind of take a picture of yourself inside. That was pure fear. It was up around 55% big, around 55, sometimes 60% big. Pure fear. That was super. I think that was the first time since you were 7 years old. I don't know about before, but since you were 7, that's the first time you could feel pure fear. Okay? That was super. Okay, because you always had sadness mixed in. You always had some anger mixed in. It was never, never pure fear. Let's try a little experiment. Say, hello, fear. Just say that.
Hello, fear.
Say, what do you have for me?
What do you have for me?
And what does the fear say?
Truth and love.
Okay, you're back in 7 years old. You're back at your 7 years old. All this fear is coming up. It has been mixed together with other feelings since you were 7 years old. You just separated the fear. What does the fear have for you from back then? What is it saying?
Please feel me. I have so much love for you.
Okay. Okay.
And I need you to come. I'm here.
Yeah, okay, so now you're here. What is the fear saying? See, fear has wisdom. Fear has intelligence. You're 7 years old. Your grandmother just died. What's your fear saying?
You are not alone.
No, it is saying you are alone. That is what your fear told you. You get that? Your fear said, you're alone. I'm alone. That's what your fear is screaming at you. And you did something then. You did an energetic thing on your heart.
What? Yes.
Okay. So what did the fear tell you?
I'm not sure. I feel a little bit blocked now.
Okay. Look, what you've told me is that your fear said you have to take care of yourself.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's how simple it is. Your fear said you have. There's nobody to take care of you.
Yes.
Right? You have to take care. Yes, go ahead.
And what I feel like is that this blockage on my heart helped me like to be protected because the people around me were so not sensitive to what I feel and what I am, that there was the only way to be protected.
Exactly. Yes, that is exactly what your fear told you. Put a block around your heart. That's what your fear said. Nobody knows. What did you say? Nobody can feel what you're feeling. What did you say? Nobody what?
Nobody was sensitive for that, what I felt.
Yes.
Like butchers, all the people touched me like butchers, and I was like being like a little plant destroyed.
Who's touching you? What do you mean touching you? What is a butcher?
I feel now my mother, like the hands and the way she touched me was like very... not mean, but somehow I'd like to
grab you. She was grabbing you.
Grab me, yes. Like you get a butterfly or a flower and you
crush it, crushing.
Yes. This is how I felt around me from the people, like being crushed. And
okay.
And I had no place to go. I had to stay there. I knew as a child I have to stay here until I can go.
Okay. So what I'm saying is your fear told you this. All right? Your fear told you you need to protect yourself. So you put this stone around your heart and a wooden door, the wooden door around your heart to protect yourself.
Yes, I feel it.
Yeah, it was a smart thing to do. It saved your life, Dara. It saved your life. So say, thank you, fear.
Thank you, fear.
And what does the fear say?
Thank you for listening to me.
Yes. So you have a good connection with your fear. You have a good connection with it. Because it told you and you listened. And it saved your life. You did a great job. And you get this? This is how it works. You did a super job. You saved your life. Your fear informed you. Your fear told you. You listened. You built the wall. You built the door. You blocked it. Yes. Let it come up. Dara, let that come up. You did a good job. Let that come up. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, you have clarity. This is clarity. This is what was happening.
I have now this picture for me being in a prison, like there is this movie Graf Monte Cristo, like being in a castle around me and totally cold with thick stones on that island. And this is that, like, an imprint of that feeling that I feel my whole life, like being disconnected from people.
Yes.
Also, when I'm connected, there is something like.
Yes. Because the thing is real. That wall you put in, the door, it's real. It saved your life until now. And now you've learned other things. You have learned other things. You have learned how to feel. You've learned how to use the angry, sadness, fear, joy. You learned how to inner navigate, and you're stepping into adulthood. And so you're stuck right now. You're stuck at the place. That's why we're doing this. You are stuck at the place where the stone and wooden barrier around your heart is now in the way. See, before it protected you, and now it is in the way. That's how this goes. So you have a good connection now with that barrier, and you can tell it. You can say, thank you for saving my life. You can tell the door, the wall, you can tell it, thank you for saving my life.
Thank you for saving my life.
What does it say? What does the door say?
You are very welcome.
Yeah. And say, say it.
I can feel the door like a living being.
Yes, it is actually. It is an energetic tool. It is an energetic entity. It is a thing you called in. You created it or called it.
Yes.
Do you know if you created it or did you call it? Which one was it? Did you create it or call it?
I'm not sure. I think I call it. Okay. It's like it came from above, like.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Like, so here's the thing. The thing is, there's another little boy or girl out there now who needs to use that thing. They need it to save their life. And if you're ready, you can talk to the door and say, I have learned enough things. I'm ready to take care of myself now. You saved my life. I've worked hard. I've learned things. I'm ready to take care of myself now. And I'm ready for you to go serve another little boy or girl who needs to shut down and protect their heart in order for them to survive. If you're ready to do that, that's a valuable tool, this door. It saved your life. You called it in. And another little boy or girl's out there ready, and they need that thing. What do you think?
Yes, I will. I want to do that.
Okay. Then you say, is it a door? What do you call it? Doorway? What do you call the door? What do you call it? A wall, a barrier, a door? What would you call it?
It's a I don't have the English word. It's like in German you have Wächter, protector.
Wächter. Okay, yeah, it's a guard.
Yes, a guard. It's a guard.
Okay. So it's a, and it's made out of wood and stone.
Yes.
Yes. Say hello, hello, Wächter. Hello, guard. Hello, guardian. Guardian is the word. Yeah. Say thank you for saving my life.
Thank you for saving my life.
What does it say?
It was an honor.
So look, see, so I have learned new things. In the last year or two, I have learned whole new things.
I have learned whole new things in the last years.
And I am ready to take care of my life now.
And I'm ready to take care of my life now.
And there is another little boy or girl who needs you right now.
And there is another little boy or girl who needs you right now.
To save their life.
To save their life.
What does the Wächter say, the guardian? What does it say?
I'm ready to protect them.
Okay. So I Clinton, I'm holding this golden cube of space between you and me. This is workspace. I'm going to click my clicker. I'm going to make a hole in the side of the workspace. But what I need you to do is hold your hands out in front of you so that the Wächter, the wall, the guardian can come out. It will come out away from your heart. It will ungrip your heart. It will unguard your heart. It will let go of your heart. Yes, yes, yes. Let the feelings come out. Let the feelings come out. Let the feelings come. Yes. Let it be big. Dara, let it be big. It's working. Yes. Yeah, all the way, completely, completely out into your hands. Yes. And you say, thank you and goodbye. When you're ready.
Thank you. Goodbye.
And let it lift your hands a little. It will go right out. Yeah, go ahead. All the way out. Yes. Good. I opened a hole. Yes. 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 It's all the way out. I closed the space again. He's on its way. The guardian is on its way. It's already going to go help that other little boy or girl. I'd like you to open a jar of cream. Reach on your bench and open a jar of cream, and some is heart cream, because the rock was rough. The door is rough. There's some wound, little bit wounded parts on your heart. Take a big handful of this cream and just put it on your heart. What color is your cream? What color is it?
It's purple golden.
Yeah, smear it in there. Take a big handful and let it go all the way around the back, on the top, the bottom, and keep letting the feelings come. Let your heart come back to life. It's going to connect right in. Yes, 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 yes. Yes. Another handful of the cream, another big handful. Yeah, just keep and kind of massage it, a little bit massaging. Big, big handfuls, little, it's warm, purple, golden cream. Massage it in. Keep letting the feelings come up all the way in the back, all the way to the back, the bottom, yes. Dara, there is so much you did not feel up until now. There is so much. Yes, yes. Let the sounds come out. Yes. Yes. You're doing perfect. Keep going. Just keep letting the sounds out. Yeah. Yes. Let your heart breathe. Dar, there will be layers. There will be layers coming up from your heart, okay? And in the next days and weeks, these layers will keep coming. So don't be surprised if you, all of a sudden there comes this, some fear, some sadness, some anger from your heart. And it starts to come up again. And wherever you are, just tell the people around you, say, I got my heart back. My heart is coming back to life. My heart is coming back to life. I got my heart back. And just tell them, and I feel sad about this. I feel scared about this. I feel angry about this, okay? You have to memorize this sentence. I got my heart back.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, my heart is coming back to life.
Oh, I feel that.
Yes. Yes, it's true. And it has so much to catch up. It has to catch up now. It needs to catch up to you now.
Yes.
But there's so many things.
Big. This is so big, so much.
Yes. Whoa. Yes, exactly. Can you tell me one? Tell me one of the things that you're feeling right now that's so much.
It's exhaustion.
About what?
About carrying all that emotions and all that baggage and weight with me.
Yes.
It's like I was running my whole life to find a spot where I can rest and...
Yes.
Where I don't have to fly, to run.
Yes.
I feel sad because I couldn't rest.
Yes. Yeah, that time of running is over, Dara. It's over. You don't have to run anymore.
It's new.
Yes. Can you say that? Just say, I don't have to run anymore.
I don't have to run anymore.
I can be here.
I can be here.
Yeah.
Where I am.
Yes. And you can tell some other people that when you meet with them at a cafe or at a meeting or on the phone, anywhere, you can go, look, I don't have to run anymore. I can be here where I am. And my heart is coming back to life.
It's like that information is sinking into my heart and it's something I can't believe that. It's like, okay.
There's a lot to catch up on, Dara. There's really a lot to catch up and there's layers. Remember I told you there's layers. So don't be surprised if the next layer comes. You'll be talking on the phone or, you know, watching a movie or talking to somebody and another layer comes up and he says, my heart is coming back to life. You just tell them, don't worry, I'm fine. My heart is coming back to life. Tell them, I called in the door. made of stone and wood, and I had it since I was 7 years old. And I learned enough. I gave it to another little boy or girl to use because I'm ready to take my life to live. And my heart is coming back to life now. And that's all it is. When you feel these things, your heart is coming back to life. Until I feel sad because of this, I feel scared because of that, tell the person right next to you and they will understand. They will understand. Don't worry. You have good friends, Dara. I think you have good friends around you. And you can just tell them, my heart is coming back to life. And I feel sad about this. I feel angry about this. Just tell them. What else is now? What else is now?
I feel joy and relief.
Mm-hmm. About?
About my heart coming back. It's like there was so much darkness and cold, and now it's like warm and light coming back into my chest.
Yeah.
It's like the light is being turned on.
Okay. Let it turn on. Just let it come back.
And I feel this movement that I did as a little boy is like I can finally open up and look around me instead of.
Yes.
In my pelvic, I feel that this coldness and contraction that is. Opening a little bit.
Yeah, it's opening a lot, actually.
Yes, also my legs.
Yeah, let the light flow down there. Let the light from your heart go all the way down your leg to your toes and out your toes, out your fingers. Let it go out.
I feel my legs, I often didn't feel them.
Yes. Let it flow in. Just let it keep flowing around. This will take some weeks. Okay, Dara, it's going to take some weeks. This will keep happening at layers. The next layer will happen. And just keep letting it happen. I have a feeling, yeah. Yes.
I feel like my roots are coming back.
Yes. Yeah, let the shaking come. Let the shaking come. There's a big shaking in there. It's, yeah, your physical body, all five bodies. Yes, 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 yes. Let it get bigger and bigger. And let the sounds out. It does not have to make sense. It can be sound crazy. Just let it happen. Yes. Yes. Let the sounds out. Yes. Don't worry. Don't worry. Keep going. Yes. No. Let it go. Yes. Let it go all the way through the whole shaking. Yes. Yeah. Let the sounds out. Let the sounds out. Yes. The sounds. Yes. Let it go big. 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 Ah. Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, you're doing super. What's happening? What is happening is your five bodies are reordering. They are coming back to life. The energy flow in your five bodies is taking new paths. There's whole new channels and whole new paths. Your five bodies are reorganizing with respect to each other. all the five bodies, and the shaking is how it happens. So you let the shaking happen. You know, you stop driving your car, you stop driving your bicycle, you say, I need a few minutes, and then let the shaking happen. You say, you know, my heart is coming back to life. My five bodies are reordering. It was blocked off since I was 7 years old. It'll be over in a few minutes. Just hold space for me. That's all you're saying. Your friends will hold space for you and you'll be fine. But let the shaking happen. It's so important. Yes, 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 yes. Yeah, you don't have to hold this in anymore. Yes, you've been cramped up, man. You have been cramped up in this tight little thing. Yeah, let the sounds out. The sounds are very important, Dara. Let the sounds out. Yes, louder, louder. Really big. Open your mouth and let the sounds out. Yes, go all the way. Don't shut your mouth. Yes, yes. Yes. Perfect, yes. Yes, doesn't that feel great? Doesn't that feel great? Doesn't it feel great? It's fabulous. You've been blocking this since you were 7 years old. God, there's so much. You see, it does not take so long. It takes a few minutes and then it's over and it goes in layers. You don't have to understand something. You just let it reorder itself. You let it reorganize itself. The world will work differently for you after this. It will work differently for you. It will look differently. It will smell differently. It will taste differently. It will work differently for you. Your body knows how to do this. Been waiting to do this until you had the clarity, until you were prepared. So you have been preparing yourself for this for a long time. And you worked hard and you did it. Keep your eyes closed. I just want to tell you something so I don't forget. You've got all these dark clothing. This dark clothing, dark pulley, dark hoodie, dark shirt, dark. You have all these dark clothes, okay? It's time for some other colors. Really, in the next week, please go somewhere, get some yellow, like you said, orange, you know, bright red, blue, you know, mixed colors, flowers, get some different color clothes, okay? And wear them. Your soul will be happy. Your heart will be happy. You don't have to hold the dark around you anymore. It's over. The dark thing is over. Okay, so really put other clothes on where you don't have to throw every black thing away all at the same time, but shift, okay? Get a bunch of colorful clothes and just wear that for, you know, just use that mostly. That'll make a big difference. Will you do that?
Yes.
Okay, super. Yeah, great. You know, Hawaiian shirts and colorful shirts, not with words on them. Not with words, okay? Just pure colors, flowers, animals, whatever. Sunsets, like life, like living things, but no words, just colors. All right. Keep your eyes closed. I want to tell you something. So our nervous system can only evolve at a certain speed. And you've been in this last hour, you have been evolving your system at the maximum possible rate. And you need some time to integrate all this. So I'd like to consider this part one of this process, okay? So for the same fee, the same price, I'd like to have another meeting with you in a week or two, okay? For part two of this, okay? So let this integrate. And then when you're ready, we'll call me up and we'll make another appointment for the second part of the same process, okay? But we've gone about as, we did a huge, this is huge. You did so fantastic. You can slowly open your eyes, okay? Slowly open your eyes. You've done, really, this was fantastic. I'm so glad that you know how to inter-navigate. I'm so glad you can tell, this is fear, this is sadness. You can put your sadness aside and let the fear come out. It was fantastic. It was really fantastic. So because you knew how to inter-navigate, because you could separate your feelings and do that, we could do this. So we made this huge step. It's bigger than I thought we would do. So, and this is only the first kind of part of this process. So in a week or two, when this integrated some and you're ready for the next part of this, we include it in the same thing, okay? It's all the same thing. Do you need anything else right now? Do you need anything else right now?
I'm good. I'm done.
Good. Yeah, so look, it'd be great to lay down, take a nap for a while, or go for a little walk outside. If you can just walk in nature a little bit, if there's some trees or anything, not necessarily in the shopping zone or someplace like that, but walk in a little outside and then take a nap, have some fruit, you know, some juice, like water, lots of water, really lots of water, sleep more, and just give yourself space. This was huge. And basically, if you could just get it, that you get to start over. You get to start over. You have had that thing, that door blocking this huge part since you were 7 years old. And there's other stuff going on too. So, but we had to do this layer first. And in a week or 10 days or whatever, we'll do the next part. But this is about enough for right now. But in the meantime, tell people, you know, my heart is coming back to life. You know, I have to catch up and just let the shaking happen when it happens, or let the feelings come out and tell people, could you hold space for me for 5 or 10 minutes? I have to go through this, you know, and then you'll be finished and it will be great. Don't hold it in. Do not hold it in unless you're driving your car or something and you pull over and go through it. Okay. Okay.
Perfect. Yes.
Cool. Anything else right now?
Thank you. I feel it's fine. Good. Like,
just... So listen, if something comes up and you just need to talk for a minute, just give me a call. You know, send me a message on Telegram and we'll talk.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Clinton.
All right. You did super.
Thank you very much.
Really good. Really good. I'm really proud of you. Super. Cool.
Really glad. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks. And talk to you later.
Yeah, thank you very much.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.